Hi. Yeah, it was crazy. It was about a little, I don't know if it was exactly 3 or a little bit after 3 o'clock in the morning. We were upstairs, and we had all of our windows open and everything. All of a sudden, we just hear a huge boom and a huge flash of light. And all of a sudden, like a heat wave came inside of our window. We're like, what is going on? And my fiancé just grabbed his phone, grabbed the keys, and ran out the door and started running down the street. And then he got the footage of everything, but he was going down there to try to see if something he could assist with. He didn't know what was going on, if somebody was hurt. You know, we didn't know what was going on. So as I was gathering all the animals and everything, just fling or just uproaring. Like, it looked like it was, like, literally by my house because the flames were so big. It was really scary. The animals were going crazy. Everybody was running out of their house. People flying down the street in their cars, just getting away from it. I didn't know what to do. He was gone. So as soon as he came back, we just loaded up and took off.
Cannot even imagine, Alyssa. Tell us exactly where you are and how close you are to all of this.
A couple blocks away from there. I'm on Reed Street, a little bit away from Elizabeth, a couple houses down away from Elizabeth. So it took the cops a little while to come down there to exactly tell everybody to evacuate from that area, but we were already loaded up, ready to go before they even got there because we'd seen everybody was already leaving at the same time. So we didn't want to stay there and take any chances.
So where are you now?
I'm actually in Detroit now. We're at a family member's house just waiting for the all clear to go back home.
And when you walked out of the house, just describe also in terms of your neighbors, what were you seeing? What was everyone doing?
Everybody was panicking. Some people were saying it's okay to stay. Some people were getting in their cars and just taking off. There was people from, like, farther down in that direction, like, trying to get through the stop sign to leave. There was cops directing traffic. There were just people outside. There were people loading up their animals in the car. It was just a crazy scene.
Alyssa, we're getting word that the actual cross street where this fire happened is Allen Road in Greenfield. How far do you live from there?
I'd say maybe about four and a half blocks away from there.
So 4.5 blocks away, and you still felt the heat and the intensity of this explosion.
We literally thought that the explosion and the flames were like a couple houses down. It was so high. Like, we literally thought it was, there's like a park actually in between there, like a big field, open park. We were thinking something was coming from right there in that, like, that open field because it's closer to my house, and we could see the flames, like, in the sky. Like, it literally looked like it was, like, right there by us.
And Alyssa, obviously you could feel that heat, and you felt the shake, right? I mean, you felt that rumble from the explosion.
Our house rumbled. We didn't know what happened. At first, my first thought, I thought it was a plane crash or something, because we always see the planes flying over, like going into the metro airport right there. We literally thought the plane crash or something. We didn't know what was going on.
Yeah, at this point, we're getting word that within the hour, Melvindale officials will be releasing information from City Hall, and then we'll have a better idea of when that all clear will be given. But DTE Energy is also going to be updating information at that point. Were the lights out when you went outside?
No, the lights were all on. We had power to everything. I just decided to turn everything off. I don't know if that was, like, the safer route to go, but I just decided to turn my power off. I didn't want to trigger anything. I don't know if that would have happened, but I just turned everything off. But everybody else had their porch lights on and everything going. There was nobody lost power. That's why it was kind of confusing. We didn't know, you know, where it was coming from. It was coming from the DTE plant, or if it was coming from, you know, the steel place over there. We didn't know. So, I mean, it was kind of confusing. No one really knew exactly what it was.
Alyssa, thank you so much for calling in. We are so glad you're safe, and thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Yeah, but
thank you very much, and thank you for covering this story.
Yeah, thanks, Alyssa.